G'day folks, in this video we're making a body for a small live steam safety valve with a 32 TPI Model Engineer thread. I did look at cutting the whole of the profile first and then the thread, but this is the sort of burrs that I got. To be honest, that's 5/16 diameter. They were tiny, but I didn't like them being there, so I did it the way I normally do it, and that's cut the thread and then do the chamfers after. I thought I'd show you the difference between a partial profile insert, the one on the left, and a full form insert for 32 TPI. Here you can see a full form insert is likely to get a whole millimeter closer to a shoulder than the partial insert is. I bought a tap to make a nut. Not that I didn't trust the thread I'd be cutting, because with a full form insert that's fairly easy. But I needed to know that I could do that, and that the relief I was cutting would get the nut up to the shoulder on the body. The turret on this lathe is really awkward compared with my other one. It's very difficult to get round it and be able to actually shoot the part you're making in a video. So I thought I'd first show a bit of overall making the part, so that you can see the turret moving and the drill over there in a gang block. Because when I zoom in a minute with the next bit, you won't be able to get such a good idea of what's going on. But you will see the part being made. Yes, when I saw that I thought, oh, maybe I better use a spotting drill. So I used a CNC drill. It's a CNC stub drill. It has the same point angle as the drill that I'm using there to drill the hole. And through the whole run of the parts, the 250 parts, the hole didn't wander at all using that spotting drill. I've been asked a few times how I deburr parts when I take them off the lathe, and this is quite often the contraption I use. That's a cross hole countersink in a small chuck in a Bosch screwdriver. I'd like to get a cross hole with a hex on it so I don't have to use the chuck. I have this one, that's a 3-flute. And it's just too savage in brass, and you'd have to blunt it, which sort of makes it useless for anything else. The one on the left is the one I'm using. The one in the middle's from eBay, and unfortunately it would be great, but it's actually worth what I paid for it. Here you can see it doesn't take long to get the job done. I'm waiting for the part to finish on the lathe anyway. Here we go, let's make a part. That's an FC insert from Sumitomo, 35 degree. There, it's just taking it down to a diameter where we can cut the thread. This is the 32 TPI ME thread insert, full form. You can see it's just touching the shoulder there. You can see a bright white line just at the shoulder. It was just touching it. I was trying to get as much thread as I could. That mark will disappear once the chamfer goes on there on the hex. There, it's gone. Just roughing some of the corners off the hex with the turning tool. Waiting for the spotting drill. That's got the same angle on the point as the actual drill itself, so that negates the issue of having a spotting drill with the right angle compared with the drill that you're using. That's a deep hole jobber drill, normally meant for 5D. In this instance it's actually cutting 8D, and it did it really well. There's a parting tool, just cleaning up the diameter, parting it off. And I can just pull that away by hand. I don't have to knock it off or anything. There you go. Thank you for watching.